Hello from Herpil. Still we are in flat land, but maybe some point we have a real hill where we can do real farming. This is a urban garden is a nice project. I like very much, but this kind of urban garden is very nice because you can make a very intensive, and it's a kind of nice thing also. If you compare big scale farming, there is no need to be so always. But here you have to focus exact what you are doing. But I saw short garden update what we have here. We make a little tour here, and some things has success, some is not. Problem has been now germination. It's so hot that many vegetables not easily germinate, and when it's getting sun exposed, it's drying too fast, so we have lost. And we have some, we don't know yet what is coming in night time, what animal is coming, little destroyer or cucumber and others. But we will catch up and we will see. But I show you what we have now. And this bok choy has been great success. We have this 5 beds. Now even this what is in shadow start to giving crops and harvest. We have been selling now sometimes more than 1 week, almost daily. So it looks quite narrow, but something 5 to 10 in Tagalog, say tali or a bunch. About 5 to 10 bunch per day we have harvested and sold. We don't sell per kilo because this is so little, so bunch is how we... And there is a more people asking what we can produce now, but there is coming already more. We put kind of cover crop this bok choy there in other beds, and it has been great crop this time of year. It's don't mind the sun if you just give enough water, and it's growing quite fast back. If you leave a couple days without harvest, you can see the soil, it's so fast growing. But on the other hand, there is some has taken quite much already, so it start to slowing soon. Maybe 1 week and we have to start replace those some plants. We just take off and add little compost and replace another seedlings. After 1 week there is about 5 centimeters, 2 inches high seedlings, and it takes 3-4 weeks when can start to harvest it. But yes, this has been very good. These beds we don't have anything else yet, but here we finally get some tomato seedlings, and this is some kind of cherry tomato what is growing quite high, so we have to make a trellis here. There is a purslane what we have harvested and eaten. It has been here, so it's a kind of wild one. Yes, here is coming when germination is more. It's coming chili pepper, and also those bed what I have made, there is coming chili. This guava we are using as tea, we have another there. And this start to be also so long that need support soon, so here is coming trellis also. This is bitter melon, and there is a calendula, and okay, someone has again eating the cucumber, so it's not feeling so well. Hope it survived, but someone like very much our cucumbers, bitter melon is so bitter that nobody wants to eat. Yeah, there is also one cucumber, but not looks very great. Yeah, and here is a loofah. It's doing okay. Some plants of that. Little fluffy, I think I put little shadowing. It's coming so hot day. This bed is little too much shadow. There is a bees and it's growing, but we will see. There is a holy basil and here is a balloon vine. Quite slowly it's growing, but it's okay. Have to put some more because here is a two is not germinated, so we put a little more. This herb bed is not yet planted. We wait when we get more compost. Yeah. Here is our compost sack. I was folding and putting there in storage. Our pond liner was leaking, so it's in progress. Maybe today evening I can. Here is okra feeling quite well, has growing fast. There is a good growth and looks healthy. And this is a tatsoi growing. Someone always little eating when it start to growing, but I think it survived and coming okay. And here is some Asian mustard plants and different variety bok choy. This is daikon radish, what is here in middle. This is very spicy mustard. And there in between has a little bell pepper seedlings. It's little too hot place, but hope it survive and growing. There is much more better when it's shadowing those radishes. And here we have a beetroot, little weird time to try, but we will see if it's coming. Here is also some mizuna and that we have putting something 100 seedlings now. Now that seems to be popular. Here we have three bees. I don't remember what what bees it was. And the undercrop is daikon radish, and then is red daikon radish, or how you call it. And then there is also Malabar spinach seedlings. And this was a snowball hickory. Not feeling so well. And this is also Malabar peanut. What is called here? Alukpati. It's also very slow. Here is a little shadow place, but it's growing little slowly. That's just a weeds. We was make a little widening here the beds, and then we can put more. And same as those bed, I make a little and this, so we have a little more room when we get seedlings. This banana has feeling well. We have watered and it makes every week more leaves and growing. And this calamansi has a great success. Just watering and little compost, and it has been, it's giving lot of harvest and flower. I like very much that plant. And then is this guava. but it need little brooding. But we use lot of the leaves as a tea. It's very, very healthy and beneficial tea. The road here is giving dust, so always need to wash carefully. Here we have some seedlings more. Not all going so well. It's too hot. That is a red kale. And here is some mulberry branches is coming. There is some green, so it's coming. And here is some upo seedlings, some peas more, bok choy coming more there. There is a malabar and onion. Finally we get some onion also. Hope it's doing well. And here is some tomatoes, bell pepper, eggplant coming more, and there is some basil. So not so much, but this is good example how badly here has germinated. Some is coming, some is not, but and it takes long time, so hot. But slowly but surely. This sides of the wall here is a little trashy still, but when we get more compost, we need 1,500 kilos more compost, and we make a patch here also around all this fence. And here is coming peas and tomatoes and more cucumber and others. But we have to protect these seedlings and others, that it's no animals eating. When they are big, I think the problem is not so big, but well, we are happy, but of course sometimes it's a little challenge this time of year here, that you should to grow only hot tolerant vegetables, but okay, that's the video, and see you next time. Thank you.